housing markets and risk of housing bubble. In the US, 10 years after the housing crisis, people still can't afford to buy or sell properties, despite low unemployment. The report on housing and renting in the U.S. was published by the State of Nations Housing by the Joint Center for Housing Studies, which suggested one-third of the Americans are paying more than 30% of their earning towards housing. Even after the housing crisis, the price of properties is increasing. Price rise in some cities is caused by cash-rich investors, where there are no direct relationship of price to the local income, interest rates, borrowings and the value of the property. The list of countries and cities at the risk of entering another housing bubble due to such overvalued properties was released by the UBS Group AG 2017. The list included 10 locations in the world where the housing rates are overvalued, and it included, for the first time, a Canadian city. Overvalued and undervalued cities: Toronto, London, Vancouver and Sydney are in the top 5 overvalued cities in the world. The top overvalued cities, riskiest in terms of housing bubble, include Stockholm and Munich at the top positions. In the Europe, London is third riskiest, where the housing market is undergoing volatility. The report states economic optimism and low borrowing rates are pushing property prices up in some of the popular urban areas across the world. Chicago is undervalued as per the report. Manchester is one of the undervalued cities, where the average house price is $186,069, which is low as compared to UK's national average price of $292,893. These areas are fastest moving properties in the country. On an average, the cities across the world underwent a rise in price by at least 20% in the last 3 years. Reasons for increasing rates in the modern cities: the improvement in economic sentiments, robust income, employment opportunities and low borrowing rates are responsible for the rise in prices. Saville's analysis on housing rates suggests the price is justified, in comparison to the alternative assets where gold is taken as a benchmark. It finds the price of properties in London, Hong Kong and New York are still low as compared to peak equivalent of the gold investment. The report on UK properties states that the rates adjusted as per inflation are almost at 45% higher as compared to rates 5 years ago. The data released by Global Residential Cities Index indicated the prices are still rising in some of the top cities, where the rates are 15% more than the rates during economic crisis. Report claims financial crisis led to loss of real income by at least 10% as compared to 2007, and the skilled service providers need to work for 16 years to get a 60 square meter apartment close to the city centre in UK. The prices in some cities rise as people are forced to live in their job cities and are unable to move to other regions. Most high-priced cities continue to see an upswing in rates, due to higher demand from international buyers, especially from China.